Hello everyone, how are you all? This is your educator Vijaya Manorama. So subscribe my channel Vijaya Manorama Tutorials. As a part of term 1 revision, yesterday onwards I have started the series of multiple choice questions. So yesterday it is part 1 regarding the life processes chapter. Today it is part 2. So let us start. So yesterday's video also all of you just watch. If you are not watched, go through with each and every question and explanation about each. Okay, so here is the question. Choose the correct statement that describes about arteries. About arteries, here it is the question given regarding arteries. So red pen I'll choose. Arteries is the main. About arteries, once you have to recollect yourself that they have valveless blood vessels which serve to transport the blood away from the heart to various parts of the body. So thick, strong, elastic walls of arteries withstand the high pressure of coming blood which is coming from the heart. These all things once you have to recollect and you have to check whether those points were there or not. Options were, they have thick elastic walls, blood flows under high pressure, collect blood from different organs and bring it back to heart. It is wrong, right? Next, they have thin walls with valves inside. Blood flows under low pressure. No, as the blood flows under high pressure only and carry blood away from the heart to various organs of the body. Okay, so it is also wrong. They have thick elastic walls, blood flows under low pressure. Low pressure is wrong, so need not to read also completely. They have thick elastic walls without valves inside. Okay, so blood flows under high pressure and carry blood away from the heart to different parts of the body. So D is the right answer. Next, the filtration units of kidneys are called ureter, urethra, neurons and nephrons. The filtration units, ureter connected with the kidneys which passes, urethra, neurons are the regarding the related to brain, and nephrons is the right answer. Nephron is the right answer. Nephrons are the structural and functional unit of the kidney which serves in filtration, reabsorption and secretion. Ureters are small muscular tubes that extend from the kidney and carry urine into the urinary bladder. So urethra is the canal that carries urine from the bladder and expels it out of the body. Neurons are the structural and functional unit of nervous system. It is regarding the nervous system. Nephrons are the structural and functional filter unit of kidney. Okay. Hello. Oxygen liberated during photosynthesis comes from water, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide, glucose. Oxygen which is liberated, hydrolysis it takes place, the water it is separated as H and O, right? So water is the right answer. Here photosynthesis is the process where in carbon dioxide as chief carbon source and water as electron donor to fix the atmospheric carbon dioxide into carbon organic compounds, that is carbohydrates. So the main photosynthetic pigment is chlorophyll A and accessory pigments chlorophyll B, C and carotenoids etc. They trap the sunlight to carry out the light reactions of photosynthesis. So the light reaction which includes with the splitting of water molecules into oxygen and hydrogen to produce the ATP and reducing agents, which in turn serve as energy source to drive the second phase of photosynthesis, which is dark reaction, which is called as, during which carbohydrate synthesis takes place. Okay, so here the hydrolysis process which takes place where the splitting of water molecule takes place into oxygen and hydrogen. That is the main answer. Next, the blood leaving the tissues becomes richer in carbon dioxide, water, hemoglobin, oxygen. Okay, the blood leaving the tissues becomes richer in, the blood if it is leaving, that is become richer in carbon dioxide because the left ventricle pumps blood into the aorta which in turn branches and delivers oxygenated blood to the major body regions and organs. The oxygen is consumed in cellular respiration, and the carbon dioxide which is produced during respiration enters into the blood. Okay, so these points you need to understand, then only these easy multiple choice questions you can answer. So the anterior vena cava, which is present, that collects the deoxygenated blood from the head, chest and arms and enters the right atrium, while the inferior vena cava collects blood from the lower body regions. Both vena cava passes the deoxygenated blood to the right atrium. Thus, blood from tissues is rich in carbon dioxide. Okay, so deoxygenated blood from right atrium enters right ventricle, and pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood from right ventricle to lungs for oxygenation. Here also, this vena cava, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, what it is carrying, these all also in the form of sentences you can practice for multiple choice questions. That's why I am giving complete explanation of each question. Okay, so which of the following is an incorrect statement? Organisms grow with time. Organisms must repair and maintain their structure. Movements of molecules does not take place among cells. Energy is essential for life processes. Then the answer is movement of molecules does not take place among cells. Because a cell is a structural and a functional unit of living organisms, so each cell is made up of molecules. Several chemical reactions related to life processes take place in the cell, and the molecules exhibit movement during these reactions. So this makes option C incorrect statement and correct answer. C is the correct answer. Next, the growth is key character of living organisms. Various chemical changes, biological reaction cause wear and tear or organelles and alter the organized structure of living organisms. So the living organisms have to repair and maintain their structure using the energy produced by cellular respiration of the body. Okay. Next, the internal energy reserve in autotrophs is glycogen, protein, starch and fatty acids. It's starch. Okay. Starch. Autotrophs are the organisms that use light as a source of energy. Carbon dioxide as chief carbon source and water as electron donor to fix the atmospheric carbon dioxide into organic compounds. So the main photosynthetic pigment chlorophyll A and accessory pigments chlorophyll B, chlorophyll C and carotenoids etc. trap the sunlight to carry out the light reactions of photosynthesis. So the light reaction of photosynthesis, it produces ATP and reducing agents, which in turn serve as energy source to drive the second phase of photosynthesis, that is called as dark reaction, during which carbohydrate synthesis takes place. Okay, so the carbohydrates which are not immediately consumed by plants are stored as starch. Homopolysaccharides of D-glucose, glycogen serves as main stored form of carbohydrates in animals. Next question, photosynthesis equation you need to write. Okay, 6 molecules of carbon dioxide, 12 molecules of water in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. It gives rise to glucose C6H12 and 6 O2 oxygen molecules will produce, and water vapor of 6 molecules. Photosynthesis is the process where in light as source of energy, carbon dioxide as chief carbon source and water as electron donor to fix the atmospheric carbon dioxide into organic compounds, that is carbohydrates. Okay. Choose the event that does not occur in photosynthesis. Absorption of light energy by chlorophyll, reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrates, oxidation of carbon to carbon dioxide, conversion of light energy to chemical energy. okay. So photosynthesis is the process where in light as the source of energy, carbon dioxide as chief carbon source and water as electron donor to fix the atmospheric carbon dioxide into organic compounds, right? So the main photosynthetic pigment is called as chlorophyll A and accessory pigment chlorophyll B and C. So the oxidation of complex carbon compounds, it takes place, that is only forms as carbon dioxide, okay, during cellular respiration. That's why the answer is oxidation of carbon to carbon dioxide. Okay, next. The opening and closing of the stomatal pore depends upon oxygen, temperature, water in the guard cell, concentration of CO2 in stomata. Okay, here also turgor pressure plays a very important role, which makes the stomatal pores to close and open. Stomata are the tiny pores which are present at the leaf surface. So each stomatal pore is surrounded by two guard cells that exist in stomatal opening, driven by turgidity of the guard cells. So when water flows in guard cells from epidermal cells, guard cells become turgid, very hard, and stomatas are open. So removal of water from guard cells makes them flaccid and stomatas are closed. So the only epidermal cell with unevenly thickened walls and chloroplasts are the guard cells. They are kidney shaped in dicots and dumbbell shaped in monocot. So it is available in both dicots and monocots also. Okay. So here is the next question. Choose the forms in which most plants absorb nitrogen: proteins, nitrates and nitrites, urea, atmospheric nitrogen. Answer: most plants absorb nitrogen. Plants absorb nitrogen from the soil in the form of nitrate and ammonia. Okay, all other nitrogen sources like atmospheric nitrogen, proteins and urea must be broken down into either of these two forms to be absorbed by plants. Okay, so here none of this, here answer is not given. So which of the first enzyme to mix with food in the digestive tract? Pepsin, cellulase, amylase, trypsin. Chemical digestion of the food starts in the mouth only. So amylase, salivary amylase, it first mixes with the food to make it soft. Okay, then esophagus pushes the food into the stomach. So no digestion takes place in the esophagus. So gastric juice of stomach digests the protein part of the food. Pancreatic amylase, trypsin and lipase, as well as intestinal peptidase and maltase, carry out chemical digestion of food in small intestine. Okay, so the simpler substances formed by chemical digestion are then absorbed small intestinal villi. Large intestine is the organ of water and salts, reabsorption from undigested food and elimination of remaining undigested material out of the body. That's why amylase is the first enzyme which mixes with the food. Now the next, which of the following statements is or are correct? Pyruvate can be converted into ethanol and carbon dioxide by yeast. Wrong. Fermentation, pyruvate can be converted, yes. Pyruvate can be converted into ethanol and carbon dioxide by yeast. It is true. Fermentation takes place in the aerobic bacteria. False. Fermentation takes place in the mitochondria. False. Fermentation is a form of anaerobic respiration. True. Okay, right answer. Next, lack of oxygen in the muscles often leads to cramps among cricketers. This result due to anaerobic respiration. It is here conversion of pyruvate to lactic acid, it takes place. Okay, conversion of pyruvate to ethanol, conversion of pyruvate to glucose, non-conversion of glucose and pyruvate, and conversion of pyruvate to lactic acid. Okay, respiration is the sole source of energy in the muscles. During intense physical activity, limited oxygen supply do not support the aerobic respiration, and muscles carry out this lactic acid fermentation to pyruvate to meet the energy demand. Okay, So that's why conversion of pyruvate to lactic acid is the right answer. Choose the correct path of urine in our body, kidney. What is the order you see? From kidney to ureters, from ureters to urinary bladder, from there to urethra. Okay, the correct path is that your kidneys are the paid organ where urine is formed. So small muscular tube, which is called as ureter, extends from kidneys and carry blood to urinary bladder. So the urethra is a small tube that extends from the urinary bladder to an external opening. Hence, option C is the right answer. Very good. Next, during deficiency of oxygen in tissues of human beings, pyruvic acid is converted into lactic acid in cytoplasm, chloroplast, mitochondria, and Golgi body. Option A, cytoplasm is correct. Pyruvic acid to lactic acid formation is an anaerobic process which occurs in the cytoplasm only. Okay, now come to the next question. Vocal cords occur in, it is larynx. How many pairs of salivary glands are found in humans? 2, 3, 4, 6. And the answer is B. 3 pairs of salivary glands are present in the humans. That is, they are parotid gland, submandibulars, and sublingual glands. So these 3 are present. 3 pairs of salivary glands are present. Next, come to which of the following structure is involved in the gaseous exchange in woody stem of a plant? It is the lenticels, which acts like a guard cells, which regulate the opening and closing of stomata to maintain the flow of respiration as well as the photosynthetic gases in the plants. Okay. Next, which cell organelle is involved in breaking down of glucose? Which cell organelle is involved in breaking down of glucose to produce energy for metabolic activities? It is mitochondria, which is called as powerhouse of the cell. Perform the cellular respiration in which the glucose is broken down to liberate energy in the form of ATP for other metabolic activities. Okay, here mitochondria is the right answer. Okay. 40 questions we have finished. This is the 40th question. Okay, the leaf diagram shows the arrangement of cells inside the leaf of a green plant. No cell contains, which cell normally contains chloroplast? It is here. Okay, here. 1 minute. Okay, this is the part, the palisade mesophyll cells. Here it is. Mesophyll cells and guard cells. Okay, mesophyll and guard cell contains the chloroplast which absorb the sunlight. Most of the chloroplast are concentrated in the palisade cells and absorb maximum amount of sunlight required for photosynthesis. So like this, with picture also multiple choice questions they may ask. So be ready with all types of multiple choice questions. Okay, hope you like it the session. Like karo session ko apne friends ke saath share karo. So be strong, be confident. Bye bye, take care, all the best.